What's up, y'all? Welcome to The Jaime Dee Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. Welcome in, y'all. Good to have you all here on this, what is it, Thursday? It's Thursday? Oh, wow. I'm not going to lie, this week has been so weird because I don't know what day it is. I was literally so thrown off by today being Thursday. You know, I thought yesterday was Tuesday. I don't know what's going on with me, but hey, welcome in. It's Thirsty Thursday. I'm happy to have you all here. For those who are tuning in live on the YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook live stream, welcome in. It's an absolute pleasure to have you all here on this Thirsty Thursday. I want you all to know I wouldn't be who I am if it wasn't for you all. So welcome into the day. Thank you all so much for supporting me. Make sure you submit and share all of my content. Yeah, help a brother out. Because without your help, I wouldn't be anybody. So yeah, go ahead and share the content. If you're on YouTube right now, sign in. Comment with me live because I will acknowledge your comments and I'll even shout you out. As well, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube because that is how I get some more help. All right, so welcome in. Today we have such an amazing show rundown. I'm going to go over the daily news. Then we're going to have a conversation on if we should respect our elders or if they should have to earn our respect. And then Kimberly Brown, executive producer and star of Daughters of Legends, running back and defensive end on the X League, and daughter of Jim Brown. Do y'all know who Jim Brown is? You know, one of the best running backs of all time, civil rights activist and actor. Yes, that Jim Brown, his daughter who has her own name and her own credits and her own life, Kimberly Brown, will be live in the studio to talk about her new docuseries, The Life of a Woman's American Football Player, her father's legacy, and more. So make sure to stick around for me, Jaime Dee, and Kimberly Brown later in the show. All right, let's get into the daily news. So the Neighborhood Talk reported this story. As y'all know, the Florida Department of Education has banned the teaching of critical race theory throughout the state, meaning teachers can't discuss race, color, national origin, or sex inside the classroom. Now, for this upcoming school year, the state has approved educational content by PragerU, an unaccredited right-wing advocacy group that seeks to offer an alternative to liberal ideologies. This new type of educational programming will teach history, but in a way that fits the new state guidelines. PragerU's website says that it, quote, offers a free alternative to dominant left-wing ideology and culture, media, and education, end quote. PragerU believes that American schools are indoctrinating students who are being taught radical ideas about critical race theory, systematic racism, gender fluidity, anti-Americanism, and that math is racist. That math is racist. Sorry, I can't help but chuckle. They think math is racist. I don't know what y'all think about everything else. I just think math is ghetto. It says it has designed its curriculum to provide both sides of the argument and help kids understand history, economics, foreign affairs, and philosophies. We have seen that our schools have been hijacked by the left, PragerU CEO Marissa Strait said. Quote, and so we have launched PragerU Kids, and we started providing great edutainment, which is like education and entertainment put together. Educational entertainment for children across America. The state of Florida just announced that we are now becoming an official vendor. PragerU's most popular content is their five-minute history lesson videos. In this particular video that I'm going to play for you today, Frederick Douglass is giving a lesson on the founders and slavery. He claims that they knew that slavery was wrong, but had to go along with it to create the United States of America. He then says he's not okay with it, but understands that it was a compromise that needed to be made. Quote, our system is wonderful and our Constitution is glorious, is a glorious liberty document, end quote. Douglass says in their video, please take a listen to this BS.
Our founding fathers knew that slavery was evil and wrong, and they knew that it would do terrible harm to the nation. They wanted it to end. But their first priority was getting all 13 colonies to unite as one country. The southern colonies were dependent on slave labor, and they wouldn't have joined a union that had banned it.
Are you okay with that?
I'm certainly not okay with slavery. but the Founding Fathers made a compromise to achieve something great, the making of the United States. It was America that began the conversation to end it. But Leo is correct that big problems need to be approached very carefully. Have you kids heard of William Lloyd Garrison?
No.
Nope.
He's an abolitionist like me, and he and I used to be friends, but we aren't any longer. We don't agree how to solve problems. William refuses all compromises, demands immediate change, and if he doesn't get what he wants, he likes to set things on fire.
Sounds familiar.
Sounds like you know the type.
Yeah, we've got that type in our time.
So, you're trying to work for change inside of the American system.
Precisely, Layla. Our system is wonderful, and the Constitution is a glorious liberty document. We just need to convince enough Americans to be true to it.
There's more to the video, right? Sorry. I can't help but laugh. They said what? They had to go through slavery because it... What? What? And they're trying to say that we learned valuable, and I'm saying we because I am a black person, that we learned valuable skills, like being craftsmen. Skills that we can use in our daily lives. How many of y'all in your community are using your passed down slavery skills? I want to know. Please let me know in the YouTube. How many black people out there are using their passed down slavery skills? Because I sure as heck am not. Oh my God, this world is so ghetto. I don't think y'all understand how dangerous it is to rewrite history. It is extremely dangerous to rewrite history. I am so disappointed in people. I don't understand. Hey, before we go on break, I want to move on to this next topic because I just don't understand how people can try to rewrite history, how people can try to lie to these individuals, why everything needs to be so political, why we're lying in these educational videos. America didn't have to do slavery. America didn't go back and stop slavery because they really wanted to. Do your history behind why Abraham Lincoln actually got rid of slavery. Do your history. We obviously need to have a history lesson live on KSHP AM 1400 one day because I cannot believe that PragerU has these videos where this man is literally, Frederick Douglass is literally saying that our system is wonderful. And our Constitution is a glorious liberty document. And that slavery was wrong, but I had to go along with it to create the United States. No. Oh, my gosh. I just get so lost for words in these type of situations. Hey, shout out to Gina Chandler on YouTube. She says, unbelievable. And Carol, good morning. Welcome into the Jaime Dee Show. This type of stuff is just ridiculous that we're dealing with. In Florida, you should be ashamed of yourself. I'm just over it. All right, let's get into this, y'all, because I find this absolutely hilarious, and I would love to have some laughs today. The Alabama brawl video. I know y'all still know about that because they're still talking about it. And news reports and even conversations around it are still going viral and keeping people entertained. Yes, I said it, entertained. So this Caucasian Alabamian woman on TikTok that goes by the handle ShoeLove99 had something to say, and I really want you all to hear this because it brought joy to my heart. Take a listen.
Now, why everybody wants me to talk about this Alabama bro? Honey, is it because I am an Alabamian or is it because I own a watercraft myself? Here's the deal. Y'all got what y'all deserve. Did you really think you was going to put your hands on somebody that was out there doing their damn job? Not just to keep you safe, but to keep everybody safe at that dock. Here's the problem. People get out there and start drinking out there on the water and come back and they done got big and bad. All right? But you met the wrong one that day, honey. You met the wrong one that day because there was people in places that needed to be put and they got put in their place. You get up in my face, I can't guarantee what's going to happen to you neither. Now, I don't condone violence, but that right there, Y'all got a show put on y'all, and that's y'all's damn fault. Don't get up in nobody's damn face acting like you're gonna tell somebody what you're gonna do on his damn dock. All right, that's what's wrong with y'all. Y'all get out there on the water and you act crazy, and come back and got that wet. Did y'all see that one man's Crocs? Lord, it looked like his Crocs got his ass whipped. Oh well.
Shout out to Shoot Love, cause she had me cackling. Cackling. I love it. But that was just a great way to entertain y'all for today. But let me actually give you the update of what's actually happening in this case. Please take a listen real quick before we go to break to this one audio clip that we have right after this one about what's happening right now. Because two out of the three people have turned themselves in, and detectives are wanting to continue to investigate this case. So take a listen to what they have to say.
The victims in this case, the co-captain, Mr. Damian Pickett, black male, and a 16-year-old white male juvenile who was struck by the owners and operators of the private boat. The suspects thus far have been identified as Richard Roberts, white male, 48 years old, with two outstanding warrants for assault, third degree. Alan Todd, white male, 23 years old, one warrant for assault, third degree. And Zachary Shipman, white male, 25 years old, one warrant for assault, third degree. We have instructed those individuals to turn themselves into law enforcement, and as at this time, one is secured and in custody. The other two are set to turn themselves in within the next hour. We are also asking for Mr. Reggie Gray, the black male, 42 years old, who was seen wielding that folding chair, to contact the Montgomery Police Department for further interviews and as part of this investigation. As the mayor said a minute ago, this investigation is ongoing and more charges are likely. We want to thank the public and the media for supplying the much needed evidence and video surveillance that we've received, and it helped us to determine the facts as they happen. Keep in mind, when it initially took place, the police department didn't have the luxury of the videos that we all have seen now. The police department was acting on statements and witness statements that occurred as we arrived. Now that we have more information, again, more charges are pending.
So yeah, like I said, the two guys actually turned themselves in. They are 25-year-old Zachary Shipman and 23-year-old Alan Todd. They did turn themselves in, and the investigation is still underway. And the situation is just a lot. And I do want to read this one last report before we go to break, because I want you guys to know everything that's happening right now. It looks like what initially started the now viral Montgomery Riverfront brawl is finally out. According to documents obtained by TMZ, the fight was reportedly initiated by a racial slur and a gun threat. In the documents, an eyewitness by the name of Crystal Warren told police that one of the white men who attacked the black deckhead yelled "F that N-word" before coming down to the dock to assault him. Warren also claims that the alleged slur was dropped after the black deckhead hand moved a couple of smaller boats that were taking up space on the dock and preventing the riverboat from docking. Furthermore, Warren told police that the riverboat captain initially asked the boat owners to move their boat, which she said resulted in the middle fingers and cursings from the white man on the boat. According to Warren, the holdup was about 17 minutes long upon the boat successfully being moved. Warren says she then heard the N-word being yelled again. She also mentioned during the altercation, she heard one of the white men threaten the deckhand, stating that he would go and get his gun. At that moment, that is where the viral video begins. Warren says her son, Daniel, tried to help the deckhand while he was being attacked and suffered a punch to the chest and bruised ribs while trying to break up the fight. Since then, we have reported the release of one of the white men involved in the brawl's mugshot. He has now been identified as Richard Roberts and has been charged with third-degree assault. It is still unclear who initially threatened to bring a gun to the fight. So, yeah, y'all, this was a crazy incident. And I, like I said, I don't condone violence. But, again, now we're getting into racial territory. And people are saying slurs and all this stuff. And it's just despicable. I just hate it here for people. Hey, we're going to take a quick break. I really, really wish you guys would stop being despicable individuals. Stop saying racial slurs. Stop teaching this violence in your families. Stop trying to rewrite history. Stop trying to act like black people, straight people, gay people, lesbian people, white people, everybody, all these different people are bad. No one's bad. There's just bad people in all communities. I really wish we could all just get along and love on each other. But until then, I guess we're going to keep putting paws on people until they get it right. Again, I don't condone violence. Hey, it's the Jaime Dee Show. I'll be right back, because guess what? We're going to have a conversation on if we should respect our elders, and we're going to have Kimberly Brown in the studio. I was super excited for that. So make sure to stick around, because we got so much to come. Stay there. can do like.
Hungry for the best barbecue in Las Vegas? Come out to the infamous barbecue and meat market, John Moles Meats and Roadkill Grill in Las Vegas. John Moles was featured on the Food Network's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Now take home delicious meat selections for your grill, and while you're there, grab a bite of the best barbecue in Las Vegas. With two locations now at Tom and Gowan or on North Decatur, you're sure to find the perfect meats for your next barbecue or party. Find us online at johnmolemeats.com.
Welcome to Hash House A Go-Go, where we've been serving farm food and crafted cocktails for over two decades. Visit us for the full Hash House experience at any of our five Las Vegas locations. Hash House A Go-Go is where old school meets new and gets twisted. We bring people together over good food and fun. Come in for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and come hungry because our portions are huge. Visit us online to see our entire menu at hashhouseagogo.com. Hash House A Go-Go. It's a Midwest thing, and there's nothing else like it.
Zen World Premium CBD offers full and broad spectrum CBD oil, extracts, and capsules which are designed to help you feel your best. Their products are sourced from the best organic hemp and natural ingredients on the market and are tested for quality, purity, and potency. They have a full range of items from health and wellness to beauty to pets. Call 725-205-9223. Visit online at zinworld.com or stop by their location at 9895 South Maryland Parkway and Silverado Ranch Parkway. Mention KSHP for 10% off in store or use code KSHP online for 15% off.
This football season, stay in the game with
Fubo TV. Yeah. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Jaime Dee Show. Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show, a real live morning radio show. Welcome in. It's so amazing being here at the radio station. Let me tell you all about my friends at the Drip Bar Las Vegas. Yes, the Drip Bar Las Vegas, which is located literally two blocks away from the Palms Casino. You want to make sure you check out the Drip Bar Las Vegas, two blocks away from the Palms Casino. You want to know why? Because they have everything health and wellness. They have your IV vitamin therapies, your sauna therapies, and more. And I want you guys to check them out because they're located at 4579 West Flamingo Road, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89103. Again, that's 4579 West Flamingo Road, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89103. And guess what? I'm going to be doing my show live from the Drip Bar Las Vegas tomorrow. Look at this flyer. The Drip Bar Las Vegas. Yes. And guess what? I'll be live on air from their location from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. And if you come in during my show, you will receive 30% off of any service. Yes, 30% off of any service at the Drip Bar Las Vegas tomorrow if you come in during my show between 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. and say you're with the Jaime Dee Show. Regularly, if you go in, you get 15% off. If you go into the Drip Bar Las Vegas and say the Jaime Dee Show, you get 15% off. But if you go during my show tomorrow from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, you get 30% off. That is amazing. 30% off. And then you get to meet me and hang out with me, Jaime Dee. Guys, they have IV vitamin therapies, stuff that can help you with your immune system, stuff that can help you with your weight loss, stuff that can help you with battling cancer and battling diabetes. There's stuff that can help you with battling hangovers, battling dehydration. They have things that can help you with better skin and better hair and better nails. There's so many different IV vitamin therapies, quick shots, and more. And then you can also use the amazing sauna. They have halo salt therapy, red light therapy, color therapy, all that amazing stuff at the Drip Bar Las Vegas. Again, I'll be there tomorrow from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. doing my show live at 4579 West Flamingo Road. Again, 4579 West Flamingo Road, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89103. So make sure to check them out. Hang out with me, Jaime Dee. All right, let's get into this conversation because social media user Keita Rose underscore went on social media to discuss how a pastor was trying to slam men for wearing skinny jeans and purses. A promoter her to raise the question and comment on if we should respect our elders. I want you all to take a listen to what Keita Rose had to say so we can discuss if elders getting respect is something that should be automatic or earned. Hear what she had to say.
I don't know who made the term respect your elders, but I would like to change it to respect the elders that respect you. A guest pastor went viral for saying that he doesn't like it when men dress in skinny jeans and satchels and purses. He said that that makes you look like a woman and he's tired of men looking like women. And whether or not you agree with that statement, my first thought was if you really wanted to reach that demographic of men, the men that dress like that, yes, the first way to do it is to emasculate them by calling them women and then insulting them. That's how you get them to listen. But then I remembered that certain leaders, parents, teachers in the black community, that's how they got you to listen. They insulted you, they humiliated you, they broke you down in hopes to break down your confidence so that you doubt yourself, doubt your decisions. They placed fear inside of you. That's how they got you to respect them. It was never because you truly respected them. Elders feel like this generation is disrespectful, and they may be. Our parents thought we were disrespectful. Their parents thought they were disrespectful. I'd like to say that some, if not a lot of the disrespect that elders get is because they feel like since they've been on this earth for a long time, they can talk to you any kind of way. They can insult you and dehumanize you, and you're going to deal with it because they're old. And while that thought is cute as hell, it ain't going to cut it. If anything, you deserve a little less respect because you have been on this earth longer than anybody else has, and you still haven't learned how to talk to anybody. What you been doing? Grandpa keeps calling you a woman because he doesn't like your style of pants, but you're the only one that takes him to his appointments. Tell him to walk. Grandma won't respect your pronouns and keep calling you ladyboy in public because she doesn't get down with your lifestyle. She doesn't have to. But you're the only one that wipes her correctly, so maybe stop. Uncle Julian can do it. Or maybe she'll refer to you as she after the seventh stain. Or maybe she won't. But you don't have to deal with it because you don't have to deal with somebody that doesn't respect you. That's why we have such a hard time treating our children with respect, giving them certain choices, treating them like human beings, because we place so much importance around titles. I'm a teacher, I'm an elder, I'm a preacher, I'm a parent, that we forgot why those titles deserve so much respect. Because you uplift, you motivate, you inspire, not belittle, dehumanize, disrespect. Unfortunately, people with that mindset, 9 times out of 10, never learn, and they don't have to, but they can spend Christmas alone.
Keita Rose. Keita Rose, my girl out there in Dallas, Texas. I have yet to meet you, girl. I love you. I love Keita Rose. On social media, it's Keita Rose underscore K-I-T-A-R-O-S-E underscore. I love how profound she is, how well-spoken she is, and how articulate she is on a lot of issues. I think there's actually only been one issue that I disagree with her on. We're going to have to talk about that, Keita. But when we meet, we're going to have a good conversation. I would love to have her on my live morning radio show. She actually is a radio personality in Dallas, Texas, as well as a podcaster on an extremely big platform. Keita Rose knows what she's talking about, because I agree. I don't think anybody should just automatically get respect. I'm going to be cordial and nice with anybody that I initially meet, but I'm not going to just bow down to anybody I meet. I'm not. I'm sorry. I'm not. I've been around too many people who are way older than me, who act way slower than me. Yep, I said it. Slower. Annoying. Irritating. Aggressive. Rude. Disrespectful. I've met people who believe just because they got older and they're maturing because they've been through things, they could do, say, and be whatever they want. And no. Not over here in my space. You can do that in your space. You can go yell and be mean and be rude to whoever you think you can be rude and mean to, but you're not going to do it over here. I don't care who you are. You ain't going to yell at me. You're not going to curse at me. You're not going to talk to me in a separate way. Absolutely not. I do believe that we should respect our elders, but then again, that respect should be earned. You should, like Keita Rose say, be an elder that uplifts, motivates, and inspires, not belittles. Now, I understand that, of course, some elders are going to have to, you know, help us teach, but have to help us learn some lessons. And sometimes those lessons come with a little bit of aggression. Sometimes those lessons come with some things that we just don't want to hear. And that's okay. I get that. I get hearing things that we don't want to hear. I get being told that we're wrong. That's fine. If you don't respect your elders because of that, you're just way too sensitive. But being cursed at, being belittled, being disrespected, being called out of your name, being talked to the wrong way, and being called by the wrong thing, like ladyboy, like, no. Not over here. I don't know how y'all feel. I see Nior Stem says we're too old to just bow down to anyone because of their age. I agree. Now I'm going to respect my elders. I'm going to respect my parents until they don't deserve that no more. Yep, I said it. If you come out your mouth crazy to me, then you're going to get crazy out of me. And I will say this. I am a firm believer of walking away from a situation and de-escalating and not stepping down to some people's level. I'm a firm believer in that, and I do practice that, but I ain't perfect. And I'm gonna tell you this right now, you can act how you wanna act. And you are entitled to get whatever response you get. And that is what I said, Jaime Dee. A human who deserves respect just like you. And that's another thing too. A lot of elders think that because you're younger, you don't get respect. And you have to earn your respect. And my thing is, why do I have to earn it and you don't? Especially if we don't have a relationship. Now, again, if we have a relationship, I'm gonna let some things slide. Just because, I mean, I ain't gonna lie, black parents and black families do install fear in people. If we just be real honest, that's how they get respect. They do install fear. I'm gonna call a spade a spade. Black families get respect by installing fear. A lot of them. I can't say all of them. I know a lot of people out there that don't do that. But not over here. I'm sorry. Like I said, even my parents can get away with a little bit until it's too much. Yep. I'm a grown AF adult. And I don't even think just because I'm an adult that I should be able to speak how I want to speak and get the respect I want. There's some children and some teenagers that deserve respect as well. Hey, I said what I said. Everybody has to earn my respect. I don't know about y'all, but no one just automatically gets respect. Hey, we're going to take a quick break. This is the Jaime Dee Show live on KSHP AM 1400. And 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. We're going to have the amazing Kimberly Brown come in after this break, who is the executive producer and star of Daughters of Legends, running back and defensive end on the X League, and daughter of Jim Brown. Yeah, that Jim Brown, who is one of the greatest running backs of all time, actor, and civil rights activist. Stick around and see what we're going to talk about. It's the Jaime Dee Show.
Hi, this is Nathan from the Drip Bar. The Drip Bar is an IV vitamin therapy center. We help people achieve optimal health through vitamins, minerals, and amino acid infusions. We are located two doors west of the Palms at 4579 West Flamingo Road. Call us at 702-846-0851 or make an appointment at www.ivlasvegas.com.
At AR Heating and Air Conditioning, our main goal is to provide high-quality service without breaking the bank. From maintaining your HVAC units to fixing them when they are down, they are there for you. AR Heating and Air Conditioning offer reasonable prices, reliability, and professional service at a great value. For more information, go to fixmyac.net or call 702-646-4000. Beat the heat and call AR Heating and Air Conditioning today.
Is your dog suffering from a sensitive stomach? Hi, it's Kelly the Cookie Lady from Mooch's Munchies. Our dogs had super sensitive tummies, and I needed to find a low-fat treat that wouldn't give them gas or other issues. Most of the treats on the market were loaded with fillers, chemicals, and chicken fat. Many of them weren't even food. Well, I knew I could do better, so I developed Mooch's Munchies, and I'm happy to be able to share them with you. Stop by our store or our website, moochesmunchies.com, and find out why we say that Mooch's Munchies are totally possum.
Hungry for the best barbecue in Las Vegas? Come out to the infamous barbecue and meat market, John Moles Meats and Roadkill Grill in Las Vegas. John Moles was featured on the Food Network's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Now take home delicious meat selections for your grill, and while you're there, grab a bite of the best barbecue in Las Vegas. With two locations now at Tom & Gowan or on North Decatur, you're sure to find the perfect meats for your next barbecue or party. Find us online at johnmolemeats.com.
Welcome to Hash House A Go-Go, where we've been serving farm food and crafted cocktails for over two decades. Visit us for the full Hash House experience at any of our five Las Vegas locations. Hash House A Go-Go is where old school meets new and gets twisted. We bring people together over good food and fun. Come in for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and come hungry because our portions are huge. Visit us online to see our entire menu at hashhouseagogo.com. Hash House A Go-Go. It's a Midwest thing, and there's nothing else like it.
Hi, this is Nathan from the Drip Bar. The Drip Bar is an IV vitamin therapy center. We help people achieve optimal health through vitamins, minerals, and amino acid infusions. We are located two doors west of the Palms at 4579 West Flamingo Road. Call us at 702-846-0851 or make an appointment at www.ivlasvegas.com.
You can put on your headphones too, so you can hear. What's up, everybody?
What up?
What up?
What up?
Welcome back to The Jaime Dee Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. If you're just now tuning in, I already went over the daily news and we had a conversation on if our elders deserve automatic respect or do they have to earn our respect. And now we have the best part of the day happening right now. We have Kimberly Brown, who is the executive producer and star of Daughters of Legends, running back and defensive end on the X League, and daughter of Jim Brown. Yes, that Jim Brown, who is a civil rights activist, actor, and one of the greatest running backs of all time, live in studio. So without further ado, let's welcome Kimberly Brown.
Woo! What's up, friend?
How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Welcome into the studio. You got that skin glowing. How you feeling?
Thank you. I'm feeling cool. I'm chill today.
You are one of the ones because you out here doing a lot of amazing things and you just been traveling, busy AF, booked, and I love that for you.
Yes.
Super exciting to have you live in the studio today. And I want people to know you for who you are. So before we get into this interview, give us a rundown of who Kimberly Brown is.
Kimberly is straight to the point.
Period. Yes.
Kimberly is about no BS. You know what I mean? But yeah, my rundown would be actress. I starred in One Night in Miami, mm-hmm. which was a movie about my father, Muhammad Ali, Sam Cooke, and Malcolm X. Mm-hmm. I model. I play football for the X League, as you said, defensive end. I'm transitioning this year. This season's going to be running back.
Okay.
So that's what I've been practicing and working on. And, the executive producer, creator, and talent, and sometimes director of Daughters of Legends.
Right. Listen, Kim, you do literally everything. When I tell you out here making moves, you really are. I actually met Kimberly Brown at the official after party for the Spence and Crawford fight, and we were at Top Golf, and you had all these cameras around you, and you were literally just the star of the entire event, and the event wasn't even about you, but you came here, took over. Talk to us about what you were filming.
Daughters of Legends.
All right, let's talk about it.
Yeah. So this episode was the Las Vegas episode. Mm-hmm. So I have like two special guests that, you know, I'm not gonna say now.
Okay.
Two special guests that come in for this episode, and then we topped it off with at Top Golf with Bud Crawford.
Turn up, and you had me too. I was one of them scenes.
Of course.
Kimberly Brown, what is Daughters of Legends? What's the actual premise behind the docuseries?
Okay, so what's behind it? Well, one, it's a superhero women's group that come together to make a difference mm-hmm. in our country, right? It's about continuing the legacies of our fathers as well as creating our own legacy. Mm-hmm. And where this idea came from was back in 1967, my father called all the top black athletes to have a meeting with him in Cleveland with Muhammad Ali. And if you're familiar, you saw Kareem, you saw Bill Russell, you saw mm-hmm. Carl Stokes, that infamous picture of them doing a press conference after their meeting. So because my dad called all the top black athletes, now I'm calling the Daughters of Legends and taking it to the next level by actually bringing positive and real change to our society. So that's what Daughters of Legends is.
That's beautiful. Kimberly Brown, you are, again, a legend in your own right, and you are a star and model in your own right, and I'm so proud of you, and congratulations on that. I do want to talk about this before we get more into that docuseries. How does it feel being the daughter of such a legend whose light is going to continue to shine on for years to come?
Oh, yeah. Ooh, yeah, exactly. Dad don't need me.
I feel it.
But you know what? I'm still going to do it. You know what I mean? So, what was the question? How do I feel?
How do you feel?
How do I feel about being a daughter of a legend?
Yeah, being a daughter of a legend.
Oh, my gosh. I love being a daughter of a legend. Especially my father
right.
is a legend.
But do you ever feel like it overshadows kind of what you have going on or what you're pursuing in life?
No, because what I'm building is the most trusted brand in the world. And two, I'm building a girl dad brand.
Okay.
Right? So my brand is about girl dads. So just like I'm a girl dad, I'm a daddy's girl, right? And we really need to encourage fathers and men to be in their children's lives, especially their daughters. And that's what my father teaches in the American program that he has with his foundation, where it teaches self-responsibility and self-determination in the inner communities, inner city communities, as well as in prisons and in jails, and trying to have, you know, men stop gangbanging and become productive citizens of America.
Right.
So my dad has always taught in that program that fathers need to be in their children's lives.
Mm-hmm.
So with Daughters of Legends, I'm doing the same by having all the women, my partner, Robin Charles, she is the daughter of Ray Charles, come. Oh, shoot.
You got all that greatness in your head. You kind of forgot.
I totally forgot. Yeah.
But you have you and you have Raven. Robin.
Yeah, Robin Charles. She's the daughter of Ray Charles. So, all these women come from men. They don't come from women. They come from men, too. Mm. So when you're watching this show, you can see the outcome of these legends and the impact that they made within their daughters.
Right. Yeah. Now, let's talk about this, because you do have this docuseries that you're currently filming.
Yes.
Where are you hoping to have this air? Or is it already bought by a big platform?
No, actually, it's independent.
Okay.
You know, so my dad always said, keep ownership.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So once it's done filming, we go into post-production. I'll go ahead and release it on my own network.
Okay.
And then after it premieres on my network, then I will go ahead and release it to other networks and not be limited by just one network who would take over the rights, buy me out, take over creative control.
Right.
And you can't do that with Daughters of Legends because we have a legacy to keep intact. We can't just be doing buffoonery things out here in these streets.
Out here fighting and doing the most.
Yeah, out here fighting.
This ain't love and hip hop, Kimberly.
This is not love and hip hop. Exactly. And you can't make it be like that. So,
right.
You know. So yeah, it'll be on my network. DaughtersLegends.org, and then it will move over to other networks.
Okay, beautiful. So we are live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show. And Kara, one of our loyal supporters, wants to know, when do you believe that the show will actually air? Do you have an actual time frame for it?
Oh, I want to do it by the end of the year. I want to do it before Super Bowl.
Okay, before Super Bowl.
Super Bowl, yes. Because we're
Why before Super Bowl, though?
Because we're planning a Super Bowl event.
Mm.
We're planning a Super Bowl event, and I want people to know who we are, the brand, what we stand for.
Okay.
Before then, I'm planning a daddy-daughter prom.
Aw.
Sneaker ball prom.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Aww.
So, you know, that's why I say it. It's a girl dad brand. I'm really encouraging fathers to be in their daughters' lives.
Okay.
You know what I mean? We know what happens when there's absent fathers.
Okay, that's beautiful. How can people that are listening on the radio right now actually support and donate to this cause in this docuseries?
Oh, contact me. You go to my website, daughterslegends.org, fill out the form, and it goes directly to me. So I'll go ahead and see that.
Okay, awesome. So I do want to take a moment to say this. May you know, Jim Brown, rest in peace. He did pass away May 18, 2023, correct?
Yep.
And I understand that that's very, very close and very, very dear to you. And so I want to, you know, give that moment to say may he rest in peace and give him a moment of silence if you're willing for that. And just, you know, praise and respect and honor Jim Brown, whose full name is James Nathaniel Brown, and everything that he has continued, who he has done and will continue to do. So let's give him a moment of silence. May Jim Brown rest in peace. But we have Kimberly Brown, who's still in the studio, keeping his legacy alive.
The bloodline.
Yes, the bloodline is very, very, very important.
Very, very important.
Now, Kim, you have other siblings, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And how many siblings in total do you have?
I would say eight.
You have eight in total. Including me. How many siblings, including yourself, are continuing to do the work for your father?
None.
Oh. Oh. So it's just you?
It's just me.
How does it make you feel? Come on, give it to me raw. Come on, Kimberly. Give it to me raw. This is live AM and FM radio.
Oh, shoot.
It's a lot of drama, huh?
No, I just, you know, how I feel that I'm the only one. Well, yeah. Then that obviously makes me the chosen one. So.
Let me give you this bell real quick. I'll let you end it on that, because, you know, I am rooting for you. I'm rooting for whatever family structure you guys have, and, you know, building it up and continue to keep the legacy alive. And I can't wait for you to have your own legacy, for you to continue to keep alive.
Yes.
Outside of your amazing and gracious and blessed late father, Jim Brown. Let's talk about what you currently do now. So I'm not going to lie. I have never heard of the X League. Now, okay. Have I done research? Heck yeah.
Yeah.
I have a master's of broadcast journalism. I'm going to do my research. But you have definitely brought it to my attention. I want people to know I'm human. That mean I know everything, okay? Just because I'm on the radio, I mean I got to know everything. I learn things. People come onto my radio show. So that's amazing that you are in the X League. I do want to ask you a personal question, because you do.
You are
playing for the women's American football team, and you are a woman who looks beautiful and young, but how old are you?
We can't know.
Come on. I couldn't find it on social media.
No.
I could find it on Google. I'll let you have it.
Yeah.
I want to know.
How old do I look?
Okay. If I gave you a guess, I would say you look 32, the oldest.
Okay. Thank you.
Are you not going to correct me?
No.
Okay, well, the reason I ask is because we understand that there is a time frame where people are actually aged out of football, and you are out here doing amazing work in the X League, and you're still going strong. Like you said, you're going to transition to a new position. How has it been playing for the Women's American Football Team for this long?
Wow, it's been great. It's been great. I haven't played sports since I was a kid, since I was in high school. So to be back with the team and working is just an amazing feeling. Like, you have that camaraderie, and you know, they make me better. So I love it now. Before, the reason why I started playing football in the first place was for my dad, was to continue his legacy in the same way. So that's why I started. But since I've grown to it and continue working at it, I see my improvements, and I'm like, oh yeah, I can be a beast just like my dad. I was like, I could be a beast. So
that's beautiful.
Yeah, I can't wait to this season.
Congratulations. So the X League is a huge ordeal. Like, it's really a big thing, Kimberly. Talk to us about, how do you feel as though that this affects your actual personal physical life? Are you ever afraid that, like, you're going to hurt yourself, or that it's gonna affect your health later in the future?
My dad always told me, he always said, Kimberly, what are you scared of?
Ooh.
And I would respond, nothing, Dad. Oh. Nothing.
Okay. Okay. But you're playing tackle football.
Yeah. I'm physical.
Okay.
I like to hit.
Listen, I'm scared of you. I feel like you can hold your own, Kimberly. I feel like you can play with some of the best of them. Me and Mark, our general station manager, talked about this earlier. Anything a man could do, women could do, and even better. And so I'm happy for you. Keep it up.
Thank you.
I feel like I wouldn't be able to play with you, because I was a wide receiver, and I don't like being hit.
Oh, really?
I don't. I played football, and I was wide receiver, and I hated it. That was actually the worst thing I hated.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the worst thing about football was being touched.
Oh. And that's the point of football.
I truly did. Track and cross country. Don't touch me.
There you go.
So what is the best experience you've had while being in the X League?
I say my new team. The Austin Sound. Yeah, I'm gonna
It's a cool name, Austin Sound.
Austin Sound. Yeah. So this will I practiced with them last season, which would have been 2022 season. And it's just like, man, it's like family.
Aww.
It's like home. Like I started with I started with Atlanta and then I went to LA and now I'm with Austin. So it's just home. The girls are great. My coach is great. He's always willing to help me and teach me. So, you know, I can call him right now. He'll probably pick up the phone.
Oh,
you know what I mean? Yeah. So, yeah. So that's I guess that's the best playing football. And then knowing that I'm doing now going into my dad's position. So that's going to be really awesome.
Yay. That's so amazing.
Yeah. I told coach after my dad passed, I'm like, yo, we got to kick it up a notch.
Right.
We got to go. It's go time.
That's beautiful. How often do you guys practice?
Every weekend, starting in January.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, is this a thing that you have to try out for or that they're recruiting for? How does the X League actually work? Okay.
Both. So they recruit and we have tryouts, which were just August 5th, which I wasn't actually there because I was in Canton at the Hall of Fame for my dad. So, but yeah, they had tryouts and they also had a girls' youth camp come out so they can get trained by us.
Beautiful.
So yeah,
how do you feel when people say that women shouldn't be actually in tackle football and that they should be more ladylike?
Who says that?
A lot of stupid people.
Okay, well then there you go.
A lot of stupid people. Let's be honest.
Well, there you go. Why would I respond to stupid
people? Okay, period.
You know,
love
what
to
I
hear
mean?
It. Now, is this a sport that you get paid for?
No.
Okay,
you don't get paid for it.
So, do you guys get funding for it? Like, how do you guys get your equipment?
We don't get nothing for it.
You don't get anything for it?
No.
That's dumb.
We get like plane ticket and hotels for our away games taken care
that's
of.
That's it?
Yeah.
But you guys play at big stadiums.
I know.
I mean, this is a big deal. I mean, again, just because I didn't know about it at first doesn't mean a lot of people in the world didn't know about it.
Yeah.
I'm just not that big into sports like that. But there's people who, like even Mark knew about it. And Mark is a sports head. That's beautiful. And so what could we do to help that cause for you guys to get paid? Is there a petition we could sign? Can we reach out to certain people? Like, what do we do?
I don't know. I think, you know, the owner, you know, is taking steps to take it up a notch, you know, take it up another level. I'm on the executive board, so I'm here to, like, help him do that because that is one of my goals for women's football, especially my league, for us to get paid, even if it's just something for right now. You know, we all know, like, the WNBA, they're getting paid, like, $100,000.
Right.
We're not, you know, women are still behind in the pay in sports.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, even the XFL is getting paid. I mean, you guys should definitely get paid for what you guys have, what you're doing. You should get health insurance. You guys should be covered.
Yes,
especially if you're playing tackle.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, yeah. For sure.
You can deal with the same health conditions that men deal with.
Yep. Exactly. I know.
So if you guys don't get paid and you guys don't have funding like that, how do you guys take care of yourselves? Do you guys have people on the road with you guys that are making sure you guys are safe? Do you have nurses, anything like that?
Game days.
Physical therapist.
Game days, we have massage therapists, stretchers, and people to take care of our body. But before then, we got to take care of our own body.
Okay.
Which is fine with me because, you know, I stretch like almost every night. So I've been taking
really good. I can tell. The way you strutted into this radio station. Okay.
Yeah. So, you know, and then I'll go and, you know, get whatever other treatments, but I'll pay for that, you know, out of my own pocket.
Gotcha. Gina Chandler on YouTube wants to know, how long have you been playing football?
Since 2019.
Wow.
Yeah. So 2018, I tried out for LA, didn't make the team. I started practicing like 3 days before the tryouts.
Right.
So,
so I'm going to just do it.
Yeah, I'm just going to do it. No fear, baby. No fear.
Period. You ain't afraid of nothing.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, I didn't make it. And then 2019, but I knew. I was like, yo, if I stick with this, I know I could be a beast.
Right.
That's what I said to myself. So I kind of already proved to myself that I could do it.
Gotcha.
But then I was like, let me go back out.
Gotcha.
So that's when I went with Atlanta. So 2019 was my official on the field playing, year.
Got you. Okay, so we only have 2 minutes left. Talk to us about your dad's legacy. What's something you want to leave the audience with today?
Okay, so in one of my interviews, I found out, which I kind of already knew, but I got it actually from the person's mouth, Mr. Gene Kilroy, Muhammad Ali's business manager, my dad's friend for over 50 years. He told me that my father is, no, actually Bob Arum is who he is in boxing today is because of my father.
Oh, wow.
Yes. So when I went to my dad's tribute last week at the Hall of Fame, Bob Arum was actually speaking, and he solidified that. So if you guys didn't know that, my dad brought Bob Arum into the Muhammad Ali deal and in boxing promotion, and that's when he made that switch.
That's beautiful. Kimberly Brown, take this bell ring. You are amazing. Your family is amazing. The legacies you all have is amazing. I'm so proud to have had you on the show today. I'm proud of you. I'm rooting for you. I'm praying for you. I'm supporting you in front of the scenes and behind the scenes. Thank you so much for, again, tuning in, everybody. And thank you so much for being here. Before we exit, let everybody know how they can follow you and support you.
Yeah, you can go to daughtersoflegends.org, or you can go to Daughters of Legends on Instagram, and you can follow me on my personal page at kimberly.b, like Brooke, dot Brown.
Yes, that was Kimberly Brown, everybody. The amazing, the talented, and the beautiful executive producer and star of Daughters of Legends, running back and defensive end on the X League, and daughter of Jim Brown. That was the Jaime Dee Show, everybody. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Tomorrow, I will be at the Drip Bar Las Vegas. Make sure to beat me there. Don't meet me there. 30% off of all your services when you come during my live morning radio show. See you all tomorrow. It's the Jaime Dee Show. Peace out.
What's up, everybody? You were just tuned into The Jaime Dee Show, live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM. If you aren't in the Las Vegas area, you can catch my show live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show. That's THEJAIMEDEESHOW. If you want to advertise your business on my show, email us at info@jaimeedee.com. Thank you all so much for your support. See you tomorrow.